Yet, it has not been done. Therefore, the student is not privileged to even know that there's a question mark after the life origins. He deserves to know that. In absolute academic honesty and moral justice, he needs to know that.
Well, and the person who holds to the fact that there's an intelligent agent, of course, we think we know who he is.
Certainly.
Is ridiculed. And yet this is showcased and defended, you know, joyriding bacteria piggybacking on crystals. That's the answer. And there's not just peals of laughter in the audience, you know.
If you laugh, you're suspected getting a lower grade than you would have otherwise.
Well, and certainly advanced degrees. You have to go before review boards and basically be screened. Are you on the team or not, you see, rather than your academic prowess being showcased and the decision made on that basis. It's more like, are you a team player or whatever?
That is the practice.
Well, Dembski says, by creating conceptual space for intelligent design, Stein, rather than the dogmatic defenders of Darwin, champions true freedom of thought and expression.
Certainly.
So all they are asking for is a hearing, basically, for the obvious, that you don't get complex coded instructions apart from a mind.
But now we have an academic posture that does not even want to admit an intelligence, even if that intelligence is not identified. We have an academic posture that's being paraded worldwide as science and as academic freedom, mm-hmm. whereby the theory of evolution is to be taught not simply as a theory any longer, not an hypothesis, not a theory, but absolute fact, and there is not even the permission of discussion of weaknesses in that theory. That is a travesty of justice.
Well, and once again, when you only present evidence for a theory while censoring any evidence against a theory, that's not education, that's indoctrination.
Yes, it is.
The very thing they would accuse us of, I suppose. And interestingly enough, even Dr. Richard Dawkins, who was interviewed probably more minutes on this film than any other, he actually said that, perhaps it came from aliens. You know, and well, what he's saying is, maybe there's some other intelligence.
Yes.
There's the point.
Yes, there's the point.
Because forever they've been saying, well, it's just time and chance, random mutations, most of which are lethal, and they know that. But every once in a while there'd be a beneficial one, they say, that would confer an advantage to the organism and it'd be replicated in the DNA. So now they're in love with millions and billions of years of time to make all these incremental steps, down for a million steps, but up for one, down for a million more, up for one. If you ran a business like that, you'd be out of business pretty quick, losing money a million days,
very fast.
Make money one day. But ordinary people who see this film will be enlightened to the bias that reigns on most college campuses and will be rightly incensed because they pay the Darwinist salaries through their tax dollars.
Yes, they do.
Dawkins says, if you meet someone who claims not to believe in evolution...
Yeah, two men on the program today.
That person is either stupid, ignorant, insane, or wicked.
Now let's get our description. Would you read that again? I think he has us in mind, perhaps.
Well, I'm sure. Stupid, ignorant, insane, or wicked. And then he says, but I'd rather not consider that. Well,
he's already made the statement.
That won't hold water. I know. No. I have a list that I saw at www.discovery.org, that a list of over 700 PhD scientists that it's the descent from Darwinism. They signed an open letter risking their careers and all of that, you see, that says we're skeptical of the claims of Darwin. Very intelligent people that are not stupid and are not ignorant.
I understand that there are some, at least cataloged now, over 40,000 credentialed scientists who have indicated that they do not espouse evolutionary theory, that there is a basis to question it. In these last moments,
well,
would you make the final point?
And another one is that, you know, the scientists that led us out of the Dark Ages and into the age of scientific enlightenment were by and large Christian
scientists. Yes, they were, the founders of these disciplines.
And the average person will no longer be intimidated by Richard Dawkins,
yes,
and so forth. And that's a good point. And hopefully the public will start demanding scientists move out of this 19th century thinking and into 21st century reality. And I think it's high time.
I think it's high time. On the program today, we have been exposed to a review of the facts, the status of affairs, where we have an imperial dogma being taught to our children, when we pave the tax dollars and a worldwide movement for academic naturalism to be taught as the exclusive game in town, the only way to gain degrees, the only way to fully be educated, now without any offering of any scientific information showing the weaknesses of that theory. That's tragic. That is transparently dishonest. But I want you to know that in spite of all that, the Spirit of God gently works in the heart and mind of every person around the world. Christ is the light that lighteth every man that cometh into the world. He sooner or later knocks at our heart's door, and we say, you know, in spite of what I've learned in the classroom, in spite of the propaganda, in spite of the encouragement of paganism, in my heart I know there's a God. I would like to know him. I remember sitting with royalty in a distant land, and the wife said, at the university we were taught that we came from apes, but we knew that we came from Adam and God had made us. We know that. Right now, you can have a review of your status with the Creator and an elevation of your position into His family. Would you just pray this simple prayer? Dear God, I'm a sinner. Thank you for sending Jesus to die for me, to be buried, to rise from the dead. Right now, I invite that living Savior into my heart to save me. Lord Jesus, come in right now. I claim you as my Savior and my Lord, and I'll serve you with all my heart. If you prayed that prayer, you have overcome the naturalism to become a child of the living God.
Creation in the 21st Century has been sponsored by Trinity Broadcasting Network. And only with your love gift of support can this program stay on the air. So write to Creation in the 21st Century, P.O. Box A, Santa Ana, California, 92711.
Creation in the 21st Century is a unique program on TBN combining biblical knowledge with scientific verification. Much of the information that I use on the program is available. Contact us. Just write Creation Evidence Museum, P.O. Box 309, Glen Rose, Texas 76043, or call us at 254-897-3200. We look forward to hearing from you today.